Hi, welcome to Your Voice. I'm Julia Locandy. It's budget season in the New York State Legislature, and the Senate Finance Chairman is here to tell us what you should know. How are you, Senator?
I'm doing well, thank you.
After the governor lines out his plan, the Senate and Assembly get together, they hear from the public in the budget hearings, and the first one kicks off in about 20 minutes, so thank you so much for being here.
Yeah, it does, and it's basically we have about 6 weeks of budget hearings on every aspect of the budget. Today is going to be on local government, so Mayor Bloomberg, Mayors Minor, and all the other major mayors will be here. The county association will be here too, and everybody giving their points of view of the budget and where they think it should change. Tomorrow will be education, and Wednesday health, and it goes on and on and on. But it's really important because there's aspects of the budget that I know I want to change, but on the other hand, you got to hear what the people who are in the field say in order to see what our priorities are in changing the budget or leaving it the way it is.
Right, and it is important to know that they are public. Anyone can participate in the actual hearing or just watch or send written testimony or email you with any ideas or concerns.
Right, we take written testimony, but the Thursday before the next week of budget hearings is a deadline to sign up. We can't have 300,000 people sign up, but the individuals who are and major organizations, we try to fit them in, even though these go from early in the morning to sometimes late at night.
Right. So as you mentioned, the first one today is local governments. What do you think of the proposal that Cuomo talked about that would assist local governments who are in distress come up with a restructuring plan specific to their needs?
Yeah, well, the restructuring plan deals with evening out the pension payments over several years and to provide immediate relief because the pension costs are so high. It's almost like a financing plan. Well, so far, at least in the media, it's hit mostly good reviews, but Mayor Minor from the city of Syracuse had some concerns about it, and that's going to be one of the main issues that we're going to talk about today, that I know what they're going to say. That's not enough. We need financial aid. We need more dollars. We need this and that. And of course they do. It's a question of what we can provide. But I want to explore whether this was a good idea or a bad idea, because we're going to have a disagreement, I think, based upon what the public comments have been. So that's the point of these hearings, right, for us to flush out, rather than looking at a news clip, what the pros and the cons are, and then see if we can make it better or leave it the way it is.
Right, and the governor also talked about pension reform and reforming workers' comp and some insurance.
And once again, a lot of those things have been said, but you got to kind of flush out what it means. And he will have department heads on each of the topics that you just mentioned and many others available to answer questions, so that we can get down to what it really means, and then we could decide much better fashion with all the facts whether it's a good idea or a bad idea.
Right, and these go throughout February to the end of February.
Goes to the end of February.
Let's take a look in case anyone's looking for a specific sector. Today, as we said, local government, then tomorrow elementary and secondary education, Wednesday health and Medicaid, and Thursday is transportation.
Well, interestingly enough, I think that all of these hearings are on the internet.
Yes.
And if you need to find out how to do that, you can contact my office if it's of interest to you. You don't have to come to Albany to hear it.
Right.
You could hear the questions and answers of department heads on an aspect of budget that you may be concerned about. And you just have to know when the hearings will be, the hearing of your interest, and you can watch as much as you can.
Yes, DeFrancisco.NYsenate.gov, and also in Syracuse on the Legislative Proceedings Channel, which is 83, Channel 83.
Good.
So as you said, their concerns, the public's concerns, really do matter. So from your perspective, and you lead these hearings, how much does it matter to you?
Oh, it matters a lot. I may have been in the Senate 20 years. This is my 21st. But there, no matter how much you study the issues, you're nowhere as knowledgeable as individuals who practice it every day in that area. And things that I've been brought up in budget hearings in the past have become part of the budget because it's a good idea and it's a better idea. And so it's very important to me. And quite frankly, despite the time I've been in the Senate, I learn something every day when we go through these hearings. And it's important in order to advocate for something to know what you're advocating for and have the factual basis to advocate effectively.
Right. And DeFrancisco.NYsenate.gov for the schedule and any sort of budget update. But real quickly, let's just go through the following week. February 4th, environmental conservation. Tuesday, February 5th, first housing, and then later in the afternoon, human services. And Thursday, February 6th, public protection. And the following week, February 11th, higher education. Then Tuesday, February 12th, taxes in the morning, and then in the afternoon, economic development. On Wednesday, February 27th, mental hygiene at 9:30 and workforce development at 1 o'clock. And as we said, the budget schedule with times and locations can be accessed on your website, defrancisco.nysenate.gov.
Correct. And the specific day stays those topics, but oftentimes we extend beyond what we think we're going to get the first section done. So we give adequate time to discuss each one of the items, even though maybe we're supposed to start something at 1, it might start till 3. It just depends on the number of people testifying.
Right. And how is there a time limit?
Well, what we've done in the last 2 years since I've become chairman of finance, it got to the point where legislators would come in, they'd make an appearance and ask a half hour worth of questions, then leave for the day. And it was unfair to all the speakers. And the speakers were there waiting and waiting and waiting. So we've been limiting time for the speakers, which is on the calendar each day. And they're also limiting the time of the legislators to, I think it's 7 minutes. And then if they want to wait, they can come back at the end after everyone has had a chance. And so it's gone much more efficiently. And the only reason we have to have a limit or we would be there forever. We need to learn the issues, but not inconvenience everyone else who's there waiting anxiously to provide some testimony.
As you told us last week about the budget expected to pass well before the April 1st deadline, which is March 21st, tell us why it is so important to have an on-time budget.
Well, it's important to have it because the local districts rely on it. It's even more important because the law requires it. It used to be ignored in the past when we didn't have a strong governor to make sure that it doesn't, we don't go past that date. And I think the date, I suspect it's going to be, it's a little later than March 21st, it's Passover, which I think is the 25th. That's where I think it may come in on because of the religious holidays. But one never knows. As long as we get it done by April 1, I think we're doing what we're supposed to be doing.
So defrancisco.nysenate.gov for more information on that. Your record on fiscal responsibility and job creation really speaks for itself, but in case that isn't clear enough, you were recognized as the Guardian of Small Business by Mike Durant, New York State Director of the National Federation of Independent Business in New York. Congratulations.
Well, thank you. I notice I have the same suit and tie on, so the photo wasn't taken today. But I've always had a good relationship with the business community because I think that businesses create jobs, not government, and that we got to make it make businesses have the ability to operate efficiently, make a profit. Nothing wrong with that. Sometimes nowadays you don't hear that too much, but they make a profit. That means they can hire people and expand their business. So I that's my philosophy, and I try to vote accordingly.
The Senate passed for the second year in a row constitutional amendment, which would reform the redistricting process in New York. Let's go to a clip right now, because there was some bickering during the debate, and you got up as the voice of reason.
Thank you.
When I was listening to Senator Gennaris talking about how one party if one party's in control, there needs to be more votes or less votes or whatever the votes are. This is party neutral in the sense that if in 2020 there's a Republican governor and a Republican Senate and a Republican Assembly, although it may seem unusual to expect that, The fact of the matter is that it protects the other party, the Democratic Party, by this balance. And that's what Senator Nozzolio was saying. And I just want to clarify that, because it sounded as if for Democrats the bill said one thing and Republicans another. It depends on the circumstances at the time. Secondly, the reason I asked the questions of Senator Krueger, it's impossible, despite all the flowery language, to take politics out of politics. When the Democrats were in control, it wasn't because they wanted to study it more. They wanted the authority to be able to draw the lines. And anybody disputes that, I will debate that. When the Republicans are in control, they want to draw the lines. So they, meaning the majority party. So the point of the matter is that you can't take politics out of politics. Although this is not a perfect bill, it at least puts something in between so that there's public discourse, there's public pressure, there's more, I believe there's more transparency, and I think it's a better procedure than we have now, and I'm going to vote aye.
Senator DeFrancisco to be recorded in the affirmative.
Okay, so now that it has passed both houses in two consecutive years, it's going to go to the voters to decide if they think that it's a good idea.
That's correct, and that's all this is about. If the voters like the status quo, they can vote for it. If they don't, it doesn't pass. And judging from some of the comments of the Democrat Party, they don't want it to pass. And quite frankly, something else will be, it'll be the status quo, and something else will come up, and there'll be another debate along the same lines. But the reason I said you can't take politics out of politics, the Constitution presently calls for the legislature to do district lines, both the congressional lines and the state lines, assembly and the Senate. But even with this bill, I'm going to be very frank because I have a difficult time not being frank. The parties, the bodies, the assembly and the Senate and the governor, they appoint the people on this independent commission. Now, think for one moment. Is it logical that they would appoint someone that wasn't philosophically consistent with what they are? So, but as I mentioned, at least there's a group that's being appointed to study it, to come up with their plans, and there'll be public pressure, I think, if the plan isn't a fair one. There'll be public pressure on the legislature not to change it to something worse than what this group had done. So there's at least a group studying it independently and making recommendations. I think that's as far as you're ever going to get for independence, because the legislature will never, no matter who it is, will never give up the authority to appoint the people. And they're going to appoint the people philosophically consistent. So that's what I was trying to bring up after. It wasn't really bickering. It was just debate on political points that, in my judgment, didn't make any sense.
And if it does, if the voters do vote yes, this isn't going to go into effect till 2020.
That's correct. Because that's the next redistricting. It goes in effect immediately, but it won't be applicable until 2020. So I think that's what some of the Democrats were saying. Shoot this down. We'll go back to the drawing board. We got plenty of time to do it. Well, the reason we're doing it is because we said we would do it, and we're trying to follow through on that commitment.
And when do the voters get to vote on this?
This November, correct.
Okay, great. Thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for watching Your Voice with Senator John DeFrancisco. For any additional information or to watch the budget hearings live, log on to the Senator's website, defrancisco.nysenate.gov.